నమస్కారం. డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయం విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం. ఈ ప్రసారంలో
వెల్కమ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. టుడే వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ది సెంట్రల్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ కమిషన్ అండ్ ది ఆర్టీఐ యాక్ట్. This class is meant for postgraduate students of B.R. Ambedkar University. Friends, as you know, our country is a democratic country. In a democratic system, the elected governments must and should be accountable, responsible to the people for their actions. As the makers of our constitution identified that there is a need of accountability to the government, and they provided the fundamental rights to the citizens. Under Article 19A, citizens can enjoy the freedom, right to personal freedom. Under this act, under this article, we can enjoy 6 types of freedoms. And at the same time, if we can observe, our country is with multi-religious, cultural, as well as multi-regional, and the makers of the constitution also gave all kinds of rights to them, and it is a duty of the government to implement all those things in the constitutional framework. When India was ruled by the Britishers, the Official Secrets Act of 1922 was continued. But after the independence, the makers of the constitution realized the importance of flow of information to the people, and the fundamental rights are enshrined in the constitution to enjoy these kinds of freedoms and rights. And if we can observe, after 1960s, that literacy rate was take place very high. As a result, the social movements were started in all parts of the country, particularly the civil liberties movements, and then after other social movements also gained momentum in this country. As a result, the political parties which are coming to the power and enjoying the power, but they are unable to perform their duties in a transparent manner. As a result, from NGOs and other institutions and associations demanded for more transparency and accountancy. In this point of view, we have to discuss one important thing, that is nothing but Aruna Roy's Mazdoor Kisan Shakti Sangathan, along with Nikhil Day, they were demanded for Right to Information Act to implement immediately. And other institutions, particularly from the press and other NGOs, also demanded for implementation of Right to Information Act. As a result, the government also decided to take necessary steps to bring transparency and accountability and responsibility in the governance. The UPA government, which is headed by Manmohan Singh, Dr. Manmohan Singh, then the Prime Minister, was initiated this bill in the parliament, and his government was introduced a bill in the form of RTI Act under the Central Information Commission. Actually, the Central Information Commission is nothing but it is not a statutory body. It is created by the parliament through the act to dispense the information to the common man, and if he can access to all these kinds of information, it will strengthen the democracy. As a result, the people also enjoy all kinds of liberties, and they will develop their knowledge in all spheres, and at the same time, it enhances the accountability of the government and functioning of political parties, particularly bureaucracy and other areas in the government. And then after, if you can observe the demand for RTI, which is nothing but the maturity of democratic system in India. As a result, that parliament which created the Central Information Commission, if we can discuss the composition of the Central Information Commission, this Central Information Commission consists of a chief information commissioner, along with him 10 other commissioners will be appointed under by the committee headed by the Prime Minister and the opposition leader of the opposition Lok Sabha, along with other cabinet minister, will be the members of the committee, and they will recommend the names to the President of India, and the President will appoint them for the period of 5 years. Normally, the persons who are belongs to governance as well as legal awareness and mass media and the areas like science and technology and other areas, those who are experts in these fields are eligible to appoint as commissioners. And at the same time, the persons who have the political background, that is elected representatives like MP and MLA, etcetera, etcetera, they are not eligible to appoint as commissioner. If we can observe, this commission which was came into force from 2015 October 12 onwards, and if we can observe from 2005 to the present day, its functioning and what is its impact and in what way it is fulfilling the needs of the people, in what way it is functioning, if we can observe that its composition and the powers, if we can observe, that is nothing but the Central Information Commission which works under the Parliament Act, and that act was provided these powers to the Information Commission, that is it can order inquiry into any matter if there are reasonable grounds, and it can secure compliance of its decision from the public authority. It can recommend steps to be taken for promoting such conformity, and it if public authority does not conform to provision of RTI Act, it receives and inquire into a complaint from the people. It examines any record which is under control of the public authority and which is under control of the public authority and which may be withheld from it on any grounds during the inquiry. While inquiring, it has powers of a civil court. CIC has recommended the Union Government to allow people seeking information under RTI Act to use postal stamps. Particularly, the applicant must and should pay rupees 10 to submit the application along with postal stamps. And the another thing in this act is the information regarding national security and the confidential information which is available in the CBI as well as research and analysis wing and other matters which are related with the national security and internal security and external area matters are not comes under this act. And at the same time, all these things which are very sensitive and they are not shared by the government to the civilians due to security and integrity of the nation. And if we can observe from 2005 to the present day, that is 2018, what are the experiences, what we are experienced from last this 14 years, 17 years of period. If we can observe, first of all, this act which gives a clear way to dispense the information to the civilians according to their needs, and at the same time, this commission which is meant to inform the civilians regarding the required information to them, that is in the sphere of constitutional framework and at the same time in the sphere of civil administration and other areas. And at the same time, the civilians' involvement in the political process by gathering this information, and at the same time they have this right which gives the power to monitor the activities of the government. and at the same time, by utilizing their fundamental rights in a proper way, they can also develop their knowledge in political, social, economic, legal and other aspects. Particularly, if we can observe in our country, after the globalization process, the corruption levels are increased, and that is a red tapeism also increased. And another thing is other ill effects are take place in the governance, and impact of other influences also paralyzed the administration, and the role of politicians also day to day not in a proper way, that is involvement in corrupt practices. And at the same time, the welfare schemes also not reaching to the mass people. In this point of view, so many applicants were applied for the information as a right to information activists, as a common civilian, and other areas, other professional areas. But at the same time, the government which provided the information to the common people in a transparent way, which leads to challenge the decisions of the government and implementation process of the policies, and the misuse of the funds, and other decisions, questionable decisions of the various governments. Particularly, if we can observe the scams due to this RTI activists' applications, so many scams were exposed, particularly 2G spectrum case and Commonwealth scam and Aadharsh scam. In this way, so many whistleblowers, they are called as civil, that is RTI activists are called as whistleblowers, and they are exposed to all these irregularities in political system, how the corrupt practices are still existence in the democratic system, and in what way people must realize, and in what way they have to understand the system and act as per the constitutional framework. At the same time, if we can observe, in a democratic system, the elected representatives of a political party and other opposition benches and ruling classes must and should act according to the constitution. But due to corruption and due to red tapeism and due to nepotism and due to other problems, the government is not delivering its services in a proper way. That is the major hurdle still in this country. To overcome all these problems, there is a need of vigilance among the common people. And one more thing is that satellite technology, which spreads the information in all over the country through the media, that is regional media as well as national media and private media and social media and so many forms of media, which creates awareness among all sections of the people, it is a positive look, it is a positive step to implement this RTI Act. At the same time, if we can observe at union level, there is Central Information Commission. As a part of this commission, so the Parliamentary Act and this composition of this commission, state level also the state information commissions were set up by not less than 10 states in all over the country, and they are also doing the same thing. Means the information which is providing through this state information commissions as well as the national information, that is Central Information Commission, to the common man, which reflects the accountability of the government and transparency of the government and responsibility of the government. Because ours is a largest democracy with not less than 130 crores of population, and at the same time, the governments are implementing various welfare schemes for upliftment of the poorest of the poor, and this money is not dispensing in a proper way, and the policies also not implementing. So, if we can observe where is the lapse in the system, where is the defect in the system, this Right to Information Act, which will become a tool or weapon to find out the irregularities and to find out the defects in the system. At the same time, the level of maturity in a democratic system, it indicates by utilizing the citizens this, that is Right to Information Act. Because if they will ask for more and more information, then only it shows that connectivity between the mass people and the government is day to day increasing. Because if they will involve and if they seek more and more information from the government, then only the connectivity will be increased and they will put the question to the government. At the same time, government also observe the activities of the common people and criticism against their policies and other using the fund, other areas, that is using of funds and misuse of the funds and lapses in the system, and in this way they will also function in a accountable and in a transparent way. So, friends, this is about the composition of the Central Information Commission, and at the same time, if we can observe, in all over the country, every department has created this mechanism, that is under RTI Act, and one responsible authority, that is information officer and assistant information officers also appointed regarding their sphere of activity. And whenever the people will seek the information and if they will apply for the information from that particular department, then they have to provide the information as they asked within the limits of this RTI Act. If we can observe that this Central Information Commission, which have the powers to dispense and to share the information to the entire country, it is depend upon the maturity of the citizens, it is depend upon the level of understanding of the citizens. If we can observe country like India, particularly it is reaching to the maturity, because if we can observe the complaints which are day to day mounting in the offices against corrupt practices, against irregularities, against misuse of the funds, against the violation of the laws, and all these things which shows the level of understanding and maturity level of the people in a democratic system. Because the makers of the constitution identified that freedom of expression, at the same time freedom to get information and right to personal freedom, which is useful like a weapon to make democracy successful in the country. And after this 70 years of experience tells us that the level of maturity is day to day mounting, and at the same time it is a time to act. All the elected governments at union level and state level have to more accountable as well as the more responsible within the constitutional framework. And if we can observe what are the hurdles we are facing, what are the hurdles we are facing in implementation of RTI Act, and if we can observe these acts which are drafted by the parliament as well as state level assemblies, the people who are getting the information, particularly right to education, right to work, and other acts which are very sensitive, and its implementation also day to day questioning by the public in its particularly welfare schemes also comes under this domain. And if we can observe that the people's maturity, that is if the common man can seek the information, can look into this angle, it shows that faith towards the democratic system, trust towards the constitutional basis, constitutional framework, and these two things will make a successful democratic country. And at the same time if we can observe the ground realities in this country, so many people who are unable to get the basic needs, they are unable to fulfill the basic needs. That is, the Planning Commission statistics says that nearly 20% of the population is living below the poverty line, but governments are spending much amount on welfare schemes. And at the same time, the act, which is also useful to monitor the welfare schemes, and it is, if the people will realize and if the people will question the authorities about the misuse and irregularities, and at the same time, while elections will come for every 5 years at state level and national level, that is general elections, this maturity of the citizens will strengthen the democracy. In between the people and the government, this Right to Information Act is become a tool or become a weapon to strengthen democracy in India. And if we can observe what are the hurdles in implementing this RTI Act, if we can observe in our country that corruption levels are very high, no doubt. After globalization, everywhere in all over the world, that corruption is day to day increasing. Against the corruption, against the misuse of the funds and misuse of the power and other irregularities against the constitutional framework, these RTI activists who are struggling to give proper information, as a result, they are sacrificing their life. Because if you can observe in all over the country, they are facing so many threats and so many problems in getting the information. But government is committed to give all kinds of information within the framework of the constitution, but external pressures were there. And another thing is, the constitution which grants the freedom to the common man, it is a base for the strengthening of democracy. With that freedom, that is personal freedom of the citizen only, we can get information and we can improve the knowledge, and we can we can spread this knowledge to all sections of the people. So, friends, here I would like to draw for kind attention that in everywhere in all over the world, wherever the democracy is there, that eternal vigilance is the price of democracy, because it is the successful implementation of any law or any act which is depend upon the level of understanding of the common people. And we hope that India also one among them, and India also one among them, to develop the awareness through this RTI Act, which is comes under the Central Information Commission. Thank you.
ఈ కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ అభిప్రాయాలని, సూచనల్ని, సలహాలని ఆహ్వానిస్తున్నాం. మా చిరునామా ద డైరెక్టర్, ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్, డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ, ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్క్, రోడ్ నంబర్ 46, జూబ్లీ హిల్స్, హైదరాబాద్ 500033.